You're watching the September edition of the Library Roadshow, everything you need to know about your local library system. You know, our staff devotes a great deal of time, effort, and resources to support the library's goals related to preschool and early education. And since literacy, or rather illiteracy, is a cyclical issue, front-loading our efforts to help young children acquire the reading skills they need to be successful in school and in life is absolutely critical. Joining me now is Dr. Stan Barrera, Assistant Professor of Literacy Studies at LSU. Let me try to say that five times fast. We were privileged to work with Dr. Stan and his whole class this summer at a special pilot program called the Carver Cubs Book Club. Thank you for coming, Dr. Stan. Welcome.
Well, thank you for having me. I really appreciate this.
Well, we really appreciate everything we learned from you this summer. Tell us a little about yourself and what you actually do at LSU. Who would have thought there was a program just for literacy?
As you mentioned, I am an assistant professor of reading and literacy studies at LSU. I recently moved here from Texas, and so far I've really been loving it, and my main responsibility there at LSU, aside from my research, is preparing future teachers for elementary program.
Okay, so this is the group that we need to reach the actual kids.
Correct.
Okay, excellent. Well, tell us about the Carver Cubs Book Club.
Something I'm really excited that actually occurred this summer, and I'm so glad that we met through the CSEL program there at LSU. It was a club that we ran for 2 weeks at Carver Library, where the library found children in the neighborhood that were interested in attending a book club and just getting a lot of one-on-one attention and assistance with reading. And it was a way to just promote reading for them and to carry reading on through the summer.
So how did, you mentioned CSEL, how did this idea actually germinate?
Well, actually, I met you at a breakfast sponsored by CSEL for all the people who were involved in reaching out to the community through LSU programs. And we discussed the need for children to have an opportunity to continue receiving reading instruction over the course of the summer, because research shows that children regress over the summer.
That's
almost
right.
Up to 3 months in their ability to read.
They can lose a whole grade level.
Right.
It is amazing in a very bad way. Mm-hmm. What were the benefits for the children who actually participated this July?
Just their excitement of having that one-on-one attention, getting really good instructional material delivered to them, and I think the books at the end of our program, we were able to receive a grant through the University Presbyterian Church for $1,000, and we took that money and spent all of it on supplies for the children to use during the camp, and then we were able to buy about 3 to 4 books per child, because we had about 27 kids in our camp, and so we were able to buy them 3 to 4 books that they requested. These were not random selections, these were specific titles that they asked for.
Right, and that you knew, because you had been working with them as coaches, that they would enjoy, because as librarians, you can lead a horse to water, but if he's not interested in that book, he's not going to drink.
Right. That was probably one of the unique things about the club, was that all the books that were read were selected by the children.
That's good. That's good. So what do you think the biggest success was for the book club?
Looking as a professor and reflecting on my students from the university, as future teachers, they realize the significance of using self-selected text by the students in their instruction.
So it's a win-win. We've got better teachers coming out of the university. We as librarians love that, because we have a wonderful relationship, we hope, with our area teachers. And then the kids benefited immediately.
Right.
So any future plans?
Yes, we are going to continue, hopefully, with this next summer. I'm also looking at other opportunities, maybe during the school year itself. Maybe you'd like to discuss this plan with you, actually, future, with looking at maybe doing some homework club in the afternoon.
Oh, we'll talk.
Okay, so something like that would be really wonderful.
All right, that's so great. Coming up after the break, Julie Williams with a rare Titanic story, one with a happy ending.